So our first asset took 60 days, second took about 50 days, the third took 4 days, and the fourth one, and it was insane, the fourth one, it got over in 45 minutes, and it was 15 crore asset, pretty decent about it. Right. And the payment gateway crashed. People, about 2,000 people invested in the asset. About 4,000 were there who couldn't invest because things just crashed, and it was like epic scene. And that gave me feeling like something magic is happening here.
Hey folks, welcome to First Check Portfolio Shorts. My name is Noah Martins, and this is a series where we speak to founders of our portfolio companies so that you get to know their team, understand what they're building, and the problem they are trying to solve. If you like the content that we've been putting out, do like, share, and subscribe so that we can reach more founders and startup enthusiasts like you. Today's very special guest is Ajinkya Kulkarni, co-founder of WintWealth. WintWealth is an alternate debt assets platform that lets you invest in financial products that give higher returns than FDs, but that are not as risky or volatile as equities. Investors are always actively looking for high interest rate products for reasonable risk. Given the scenario where FD and debt mutual fund returns have dropped considerably, there is a huge vacuum for products that give 2-3% higher returns than FD and are less volatile than equities. I had a truly interesting conversation with Ajinkya. We spoke about how he discovered this problem, how he met his three co-founders, and the work culture at WintWealth. He also told a really inspiring story about launching their fourth product towards the end of the episode. So do stick around to learn more. Ajinkya, thank you so much for joining me. It's a pleasure to host you.
Hey, thanks Noah for having me here. A pleasure to be here.
Awesome. Okay, so I'm going to start by quoting Michael Scott if you've watched The Office. I believe WintWealth might be a fairly complicated product for people to understand if they don't have a strong financial background. So please, can you explain this to me like I'm five?
Sure. So at WintWealth, you basically get to invest in products that give higher return than FDs, but are not as risky or as volatile as equities. I mean, that's what we do.
All right. And explain to me like I'm not five now. Just what is WintWealth?
Yeah. So what we realize is the problem that like retail investors have a lot of money, and equity is not for all. Most other people don't like the risk or volatility of equity. FD returns are low. It is not a tax efficient instrument. So people know that FDs are not great, but they still settle for FDs for lack of choice or lack of education. So we realize there is this white space between FDs and equities, right? And we also knew from our experience that there are many such asset classes which are available, but they are available for ultra rich people in higher ticket size, let's say 10 lakh, 20 lakh. And what we are basically trying to do is bite-sizing that and making those higher yield products available for retail investors in small ticket size of 10,000, right? So we are basically democratizing those asset classes. People didn't have access to those. And that means that include people like us, right? So we are making it available for people like us.
That's awesome. And why did you decide to work on this? How did you discover this problem? And what was that initial stage of finding this? Yeah.
So I had a startup earlier. Didn't work out great. We got acquired. But I was very sure that I'll come back and build a great startup. So, and then I was working at Credit Vidya and then at MSwipe. Right. So at that time, whatever money I was saving, I didn't want to learn investing. So I started parking that money in my father's business. My father has a small manufacturing business. And he had a bank loan at about 12%. So he said, I'll give you 11%. And I said, okay, makes sense. Let's move on. And there used to be always discussion among colleagues, friends, saying, where do you put money? Which stock? Which mutual fund? Ye bhagne wala hai, yaha dalna chahiye, yaha dal de, yaha ye girne wala hai, x, y, z. And I used to keep quiet. People used to ask me, where do you put your money in? And I used to jokingly say ki main to bapu ke dhande mein dal ke baitha hu. And people used to like that ki 11% hai, acha hai. And a colleague at MSwipe once said ki yaar mere ko bhi isme dalna hai. And I told him ki haan theek hai, de de mujhe paisa. And he immediately transferred about 20,000 rupees on Google Pay. Back then it was Tej Pay. And that actually was like aha moment, saying something is cooking here. And that's what led to discovery, saying this big white space in between FDs and equities. And there are these new asset, there are a lot of asset classes which are already available, but they're not just accessible for retail investors. And then we started looking at is it possible that we can build something. It seemed very cool because we wanted ourselves to invest in these asset class, and we didn't have that kind of money, 10 lakh, 20 lakh. Right. So it seemed like a hard problem to solve, but very exciting because we are solving for ourselves. It made sense to build something that we would ourselves use and something that is very cool.
Yeah, very cool. Where have we come from there? Like how what's the progress been so far? What's the traction? What does your team look like right now?
Sure. So we launched this in last December. So about 11 months now. We recently crossed 100 crore of AUM. About 6,000-7,000 investors and about 50,000 plus in wait list. Things have been pretty good. The growth has been phenomenal and much more than we expected. It came much more early than we hit the PMF pretty early. So been fortunate on that front and pretty exciting journey.
That's awesome. And what about how big is your team right now?
We are about a little more than 40. Right. So
okay,
that like getting bigger every few days.
It's a pretty big quite a lot of progress in such a short period of time. Tell me about how you and your co-founder met and what that initial conversation between the two of you like was when you decided to work on this together, and also talk to me a little bit about why people should want to join your team. What is the culture like at WinWealth? What kind of ownership over their roles can people expect when they're working at WinWealth?
So I and Abhik, one of my co-founders, right? We are classmates from our IIT days, right? And I organized his bachelor's, he organized mine. So he was also co-founder in my last startup. So it was always clear to me that whenever I do something of mine, Abhik will be a co-founder or a very early team member. When I wanted to build something like that, had a consumer angle, so Abhik joined. Abhik and Shashank is our tech co-founder, CTO. He worked together in Shopper even previously. So, and I had been meeting Shashank for the last 4 years on and off, thinking of jamming different ideas. Right. So, and Anshul I knew because I worked in a lending space, and Anshul did very, very special, very niche of structuring work. Right. And he was always open to explore new ideas. So I and Anshul were in touch. And so that's how we met and started WinWealth. Right? Why people should join WinWealth is if you really like the problem. Right. So it is going to be a hell of a journey. Working at a startup, you get a feel of a startup. Obviously, wealth creation is one big factor, right? But apart from that, what we look for is exceptional folks who want to, who want to make some impact, right? Kuch karna hai. We don't want people who are career focused, looking for their next move, right? We want people who really identify the problem, who want to make an impact, right? And we look for people who take their work very, very seriously, but don't take themselves very seriously.
And, very interesting.
Right. And that also makes it a fun place, right? We play cricket in the office. We go on trips. We hang out, right? And we have built a very different kind of culture. We are inspired by Netflix, right? So where we treat everyone like adults. So there is humongous level of transparency. Anybody can discuss anything with each other, even their salaries. Right. And we give the bad news also to team very frequently so that there is ownership. We are one of the highest ESOP pool compared to most of the startups in the industry. Right. So it's a very different kind of culture, very unique kind of culture we are building. But idea is we want people who are missionary, who want to make an impact and not just looking for their next career move or something. So we want people who strongly identify this problem and feel strongly about building this and democratizing investments, this different asset class for retail investors.
That's awesome. That's genuinely great to hear. Okay, I'm going to ask you one last question before we end this. So have you watched Silicon Valley? Have you watched the show Silicon
Valley?
Yeah. So towards the end of every season, before they're doing this always blue with the ball, they have this sort of moment where they realize that, damn, we're actually building something that matters here, right? Have you felt that? I'm sure you have. So could you tell me some moments, maybe one or two from your journey, where you've just had to pause and be like, damn, we're actually building something cool here.
Yeah, sure. So generally, we measure the progress by time. Like, we bring one asset after another, and we basically measure how much time does it take for the asset to get 100% subscribed. So our first asset took 60 days. Second took about 50 days. The third took 4 days. And the fourth one, and it was insane, the fourth one. It got over in 45 minutes. And it was a 15 crore asset, pretty decent amount of
money. That's crazy.
And, like, and nobody had predicted, even in the team. Even the, like, whenever asset goes live, we generally have like a prediction game. So whoever predicts right, get the pizza party or something. But like the most aggressive prediction was 2 days, and it went in 45 minutes. Right? And that was something like, what the fuck just happened?
Insane.
Right. And the payment gateway crashed. People, about 2,000 people invested in the asset. About 4,000 were there who couldn't invest because things just crashed. And it was like epic sin. And that gave me feeling like something magic is happening here. Like, we are onto something very, really, really big.
That's awesome. That's awesome. That's genuinely so cool. I can't even imagine what that must have felt like.
Yeah, this is a typical startup, right? So obviously we are very happy, something really unexpected. But payment gateway had crashed. So there are a lot of people who were angry at us. They were lashing out on Twitter saying, humko kaise nahi mila, ye nahi mila. And all the team had to get on chats and calls just to pacify investors and talk it through, right? So
yeah.
Which was
there's like, always a fire somewhere.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you so much, Ajinkya. It was great talking to you. And it's very cool to see what you're building and how well it's catching on. And I wish you and your team the best of luck.
Thank you. I really enjoyed this conversation.